In this video, I'll explain how to teach subtraction with borrowing using the place value house. Children should know how to do normal subtraction without borrowing before you go into this chapter. To teach subtraction with borrowing, write a number on the board, say 25, and ask students to show this number using the place value house. Now write a minus 7 after the 25. Ask them, what does minus mean? Minus means to remove, to take away. What do they have to take away? 7. But are there 7 beads in the house of units? No. Now what needs to be done? We cannot take away 7. But we do have beads in the house of 10. So let us borrow from the house of 10, take away 1 rod. But house of units cannot have 10 or cannot hold a rod. It can only hold units. So what should we do? We should exchange this 1 rod for 10 beads. This exchanging is borrowing. We show it while doing the sum on paper by borrowing a 10. So put away the rod, take these beads, and now we need to remove 7. So remove the 7 beads. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And whatever remains, put them again into the house of units. Now, how many beads are there in the house? In the place value house, we have 18 beads in the place value house. So that is the answer to the subtraction sum. Give children a lot of practice in borrowing from the house of 10 to the house of units. Use the same logic when you have to borrow from the house of hundreds to the house of tens. This visual way of actually borrowing helps them to understand the concept when they do it on paper. Make sure that children write down the answer of the sum in the worksheet. Also make them do the sum on paper as they solve it using the place value house.